Hello everybody, welcome to Thomas Plays Games. We're continuing our German Reich campaign, trying to force Poland and France to capitulate by the 1st of January 1490. And I think we're doing a pretty good job, taking out Poland pretty quickly without France even joining the war, as well as being able to actually defeat the Netherlands rather than just make them capitulate, which means we get all of this beautiful land with its rubber and oil, which is just amazing to have. So people will be trading with us for rubber rather than with the United Kingdom or the Netherlands. Okay, so let's continue on, go down to speed 2. You can see our world tensions increased quite a lot. We're going to attack Brussels next, or actually Belgium, taking over them so we can get a very long, large border. And that sound means that somebody is trying to land troops on our soil. We'll have to stop that from happening. How's our equipment doing? We're still a little low on tanks, but it should last us long enough for the campaign. And how are our tanks going? Still getting in position. So once those guys are in position, I'll worry about actually declaring the war. Yeah, it'd be nice to take Luxembourg out, but I don't think they're worth it until we take Belgium, because I don't want to declare war on Luxembourg and have French troops enter in there. See, the French line along the Belgian border is significantly weaker than the Maginot line itself. Maginot line gets like a 10 fort bonus, which is, oh, it's really, really bad to attack into that. So we're more just station troops so that we don't lose anything. There's a port strike. Seems they're bombing our troops, or our boats at least. Definitely not convenient. And where are our tanks? They're almost all in position, building up the plan preparation bonus. Just waiting a couple days. We do not have air superiority in the northeast of Germany, and we're not going to get it for a long time. Let's put that at lowest. Actually, no, I think that works better. I want reinforcements first, then new troops, then upgrades, because upgrades I don't think are going to be useful at all. Yeah. We stationed our troops along our border closest to England so that they can't land any more troops when I'm not paying attention. And how are our tanks? Excellent. They seem ready. These guys, I would also like along this border, though I'm not as concerned with how they're going to do. Yeah, we're just waiting. It's likely that I'll take off some of these guys and move them to the front border as the border gets longer with France when we push in, but I don't think it's worth worrying about right now. So let's do this. Call in our allies and tanks, move forward please. Oh, Belgium did join the allies and the war merged. Like you to move in here, please. Taking as much land as possible. Just pushing in, trying to very, very quickly push them before France can redirect some of its troops to the Belgian border. We can invite Italy to our faction, so we'll absolutely love to have Italy as part of the Axis. Beautiful. And Italy wants Yugoslavia. Interesting. Volunteer forces arriving. Resistance in Krakow. Most of that resistance should go away later on. Not too concerned with resistance, though it would be nice to not have it. Gotta take there's only it's a very small province, so we just gotta take a couple of the major cities. And it should fall, though they likely have very high unity. Yeah, 75% is not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, you guys are all from this group on the Belgian border. Computing machines. Let's go for some decryption. Would like to not have to worry. But a lot of those, I would like to not have to get a malice to my actual abilities. Go in. What do we need the most of? Probably we should fill out support equipment. yeah, definitely fill those out. And yeah, we're just pushing in, taking over Belgium. It seems to be going well. It's a little slower than I would have liked, though. Trying to push in a weird direction. And I think I will attack Luxembourg just to see if we can't speed it up. Call in my allies. And let's see. Luxembourg joined the allies, unfortunately. But we have so many troops that I think we'll be able to defeat them without too much issue. And yeah, just slowly pushing into Belgium. The war for Brussels, or the battle for Brussels, is a little slower than I would have liked. These guys getting in position. Like everybody to move in. Even their artillery are going in now, so it should go a lot faster now that we have soft attack and tanks for the mobility. And then the goal is just to kind of move along the north and try to make a bulge that goes down and loops around to France. Do they have no troops in the south? That is an interesting decision. Don't have fighter twos, unfortunately. And let's see. I would like this division to go to the max size possible. Just get 1,000 fighters in there as they get built. Let's assign an ace to our groups. Yeah, they should fall the moment we take Brussels. And Luxembourg will fall, and then France will fall. It'll be a nice short battle, a bit of preparation, and then a bit of domination. Are these guys not moving? They are all moving to Brussels. Yeah, I prefer to not have losses in the north, but I'd rather have, you can see the planes flying around up here. Belgium has capitulated, so only troops at the Belgian border are going to be an issue now. Let's draw the offensive that I would like to follow along here, definitely following the rivers. Don't want to get into any unnecessary problems. Let's go along. These guys here. They're assigned here. And all these troops would like to make a... let's just draw a long, unusual one and see how it goes. And I'll micro the tanks as I can. They seem to be doing quite well, though. I would like as quick a push as possible to Paris. The more we can hold them down, the better. And we'll get there when? 18 hours. We'll get there in 11. So, not very convenient, unless I can trap some of the troops along here. And this should go quickly. Good, good. And we're just on a race to Paris now. If they're going to open up the Maginot Line, I will try to hold them there. France stations lots of troops along the Maginot Line and not too many in the rest of the borders, so if I can hold as many troops as possible here, that means easier time pushing into the north and into Luxembourg. Actually prefer you go there just to hold off while we rush for Paris. And how much of France do we need to take? France has very, very low national unity. They're a time of a lot of turmoil in their actual battles, so they're pushing into us. Excellent, took them out. I want these two tanks to get there as fast as humanly possible. Less than a day. I'd like to make a pocket with these three troops. The more troops we eliminate, the less difficulties we're going to have. We're actually somehow winning here, but the entrenchment bonus, as well as the Maginot Line defense, is just... It means we're never going to do anything, but if we can hold them there, then we should have a huge benefit. And, beautiful. We made it to France, or Paris. The fall of Paris. While fighting still rages elsewhere in France, reports have come in that German troops are entering Paris. The capital was declared an open city by French forces. Declared an open city by French forces moments before their last units retreated. Several columns of German troops recreated the Prussian Victory Parade of 1871, marching downward the Champs-Élysées. I believe I pronounced that right. Well, probably not, actually. While Parisians looked on in stunned silence, military experts predict that the collapse of France is imminent, a victory for the Vanderland. Oh, should we establish Vichy France? Might as well. And is that France capitulation? That is France capitulation. Vichy France declared war. Excellent. So, the second armistice at Coping. An armistice between the German Reich and the French Third Republic has been signed in Compiègne, in the very rail carriage in which the German surrender in World War I was negotiated. Under the terms of the armistice, a French government, under Marshal Pétain, based out of Vichy, will continue to administer most of the southern France, while the rest of the country falls under German occupation zone. Some French officers have vowed to continue resistance from abroad, but this puts an effective end to the fighting in France, at least for the time being. Excellent. So, let's see. I think once the day ticks, we will... Oh, there we go, true Blitzkrieg. And I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but I got the little pop-up for the achievement. So that is that is the achievement for this campaign. A little fast. So we might have to look into Yugoslavia... Maybe some Baltic countries or go from some other dominations as time goes on. But we'll definitely clean up the French forces and see where to move from here. Move our tanks in here, over there. We'd like you over there. Just to hold out. It was a very fast. Okay, so Adolf Hitler's announced that the cowardly French nation could no longer withstand the pressure from the overwhelming presence of the German forces throughout the country. The French government has chosen to flee the country and gone to exile. Their main forces have capitulated, and the German Reich is now in control of the home area. Though the war against the remaining allies continues elsewhere, this is a great victory for all of the Axis. Great news. The flight of Rudolf Hess. There's a lot of events happening right now. Deputy Führer Rudolf Hess was arrested by the Home Guard soldiers in Scotland yesterday after parachuting from heavy fighter. An accomplished pilot, he apparently flew across the Northern Sea, taking care to stay out of radar range before veering west towards Britain. Hess appeared to have taken it upon himself to negotiate a peace treaty between Britain and Germany. Although Berlin denounces him as a madman and has stripped him of all political offices, British authorities have not been available for comment. Wassen. Don't know what that means. My German is not the greatest. That was remarkably quick. And we're not even in the second Vienna Award. So we took... Oh, Luxembourg capitulated. There we go. And I'm not going to bother reading that. Luxembourg is a very small country. Let's take our tanks... And we'll place them along the Romanian border. Actually, I'd prefer if the tanks were in Lithuania. I believe Lithuania is largely flatland and forest, which should make any assault very fast. The rest of our troops will just station along the border. Make a fallback line along the northern border in case there's any... assault from the British. Don't want them landing in our on our territory, on our newly gotten territory. And that's the nice thing about these tanks, they're just so fast. Unless they're, when they're fighting, they're not the strongest, but they are extremely quick to move. Move some heavy tanks. Let's still make more Panzer IIs, just while we can. And we are doing remarkably well. Could I train any troops and set them up? We can't, unfortunately, set them over here. That would be very good to have, just taking this little bit of land. But the capitulation of the Netherlands before they were able to join the Allies means that we took all of this land. So, although we might lose a bit of Papua New Guinea, or... this is New Guinea Island, I'm not positive. Even though we're going to lose some stuff over there, controlling this land and the... oh gosh, my geography is failing me. The state of... the Sunda Islands? As long as we don't lose any of this land in Southeast Asia, then we're going to get a lot of oil, and we won't have to worry for the rest of the game, likely. Now is when we begin our attempts to take London. So we're going to actually delete that, change this to transport planes. I would like to do that. That's all right. Fill those out. Transport planes. We need transport planes and fighters if we want to hold any land here. I don't think we'll be doing naval invasions. I think air invasions are the way to go if we're going to try to end the war. And let's see who we'd have to actually defeat. So the only major faction left is the United Kingdom. So we're going to be researching airplanes next. We'll be researching paratroopers next so that we can try to land troops on there and get a dock. So that from the dock we can start transporting our real armies. And in the meantime we'll be attacking Denmark, Sweden. And countries like that. Just getting ready for an assault on United Kingdom so that we could prepare for any other eventual campaigns. They're still justifying the role in Yugoslavia. Which air wing has no mission? The tactical bombers. I think I'll move them here. Okay, let's put our tactical bombers all in here. Interwar bombers, tactical bomber. All of them, please. And I guess the interwar bombers as well. And once they're there, we'll... I don't think it's a good idea to waste them on controlling the area up here. But we definitely want to control southern England airspace. That is a lot of forts. Or a lot of production. Let's make some more synthetic oil, just in case we lose Southeast Asia. Down here, where it's more likely than not safe, and a couple more factories in all this other land. Yeah, the only problem is any sort of unrest. We can switch it to the gentlest occupation, which will reduce any penalties we have, at least a bit. And I trust Vichy France can deal with all the land here, retaining some of their... Oh, excellent. They even control some land down here. Let's see if Italy can do anything in Africa. I'd be surprised. I find it dubious that they'll be able to make any real headway in an assault, or in a campaign in Africa. Guess why not put some more civilian factories out here. I would like some anti-air along the north. And if we have the production capacity, it doesn't hurt. And we should... Oh, we cannot do radar yet. Though it would be very beneficial to have. Let's edit this, pull it down to here. Excellent. And we're still not making up on our artillery deficit, but soon I think it'll even out. Just the first line. We don't want to hamper our transport plane growth. We just got to go back up to speed 3 and wait. We're not going to be doing any sort of naval sea lion, so we'll do like a air lion. Sort of Operation Hawk or something along those lines. Getting ready to land. Likely down here. Our tanks. How are our tanks? Oh, they're getting close. You guys have no order. I guess Switzerland would hurt to take. What kind of resources do they have? Any 8? I've seen worse. Now, Denmark. Can't justify war on them yet, but we will get an option too soon. Nope. Very low supplies around here. Might as well help out get rid of these last few British troops that were landed. Excellent. So we just gotta hold out here and wait for a bit of technology so that we can finally take out the United Kingdom. We have significantly more land than they do. The only thing that would be a problem for us is if we attacked the Soviet Union or if they attacked us. I'd be very surprised if they attacked us anytime soon, but crazier things have happened, I guess. I don't think they even have... Yeah, they still have the officers purged penalty for 3 years. So I wouldn't... If I was them, I wouldn't want to attack, so I'm betting on them not wanting to as well. I might as well. Just for war goals on all of their stuff. You as well, Estonia. It's a few small countries, and I guess since it only takes 25 days, we might as well try to take Denmark. Although I don't think we'll be getting Iceland or Greenland. Man, these guys are not doing a great job. Oh, the second Vienna Award, and we have our alliance with Italy. Excellent. So, give... all of Transylvania, or Transylvania shall remain Romanian. Well, I like Hungary. They're in my axis. Romania isn't, so I guess I'll be giving it to all of Hungary. Second Vienna Award. Recognizing that a new order has been established in Europe, we have been asked by Hungary and Romania to arbitrate in a territorial dispute between the two countries. Transylvania was taken from Hungary and incorporated into Romania in one of the many ill-conceived changes forced upon the world at Versailles. Should the northern Transylvanian be returned to Hungarian control? I think they should get all of Hungary, or all of Transylvania. Let's see if they get it. They rejected our verdict, refused to abide by any decision reached by the Second Vienna Award. The delegation has been recalled and no territory has been surrendered. Well, I guess they'll be losing their whole country then. Troops. Yeah, these guys are the ones there. I'll actually place them on the Romanian border to take all of Romania instead of on Switzerland. I guess we'll keep neutral Switzerland as Switzerland. I don't like that they rejected this. German Reich acted as arbiter. Romania have embarrassed us. We will not stand for this injustice. So, alliance with Spain would be really nice. Getting more people into the Axis. Yeah, France does not exist or has capitulated. Current ruling party is fascist. So, we will expand the Axis's power. I wonder if we could invite Japan yet. They seem to be doing quite well in their war already. Like, surprisingly well. I haven't seen countries do... I've seen Japan do very, very poorly against China. But it really depends on how well things go. On the 4th of December, that's when our thing will be done. Expeditionary Force wants to send us 27 troops. I do not think we need them, Hungary. Ah, I see. I was looking at the different estates, trying to figure out where this tiny piece of land was in these three. Turns out it wasn't in any of them. So, available land. How does he think he will fare? Excellent. So now we will get paratroops. So that is our major plan for attacking Great Britain. And why do you think you would do poorly? You're still preparing and you're not in position. Well, once that's done, then I think we'll just attack Romania. Demand they give land back, give the land to Hungary. Remarkable. But, please get rid of him. Thank you. You are... Oh, so this is a flavor event because we're fabricating on a bunch of different countries. So it's not an actual historical event that might have happened. It may have happened, but the event is more just so that if you're fabricating, there is something happening. Or the resources in the Middle East. Yeah. Lots of different things. I guess we're getting state modifier, of course. And how are we... Oh, we're getting full resources here. So we should have hundreds of... Oh, wow. That is a lot of troops in North Africa. I was not expecting to see this. It might be that when you take France, then Italy doesn't have to focus anywhere in Europe. And can actually entirely look at North Africa, or Africa in general. So we've finished on... Here, oh. I guess that means we have our war goal. So, France is guaranteeing them. And here we go. Yep, just those two. Now the rest of the Balkan states are not fans of me, but they're not. They're not that important. Now, why is it so much low? They're stronger than us? Really? Even along this border. Now, is that might just be because we have a very low supply of artillery, and it's not going up as fast as you might hope. But yeah, we'll just gobble up the Balkan states. Hopefully, stopping the Soviet Union from getting any major expansions. I'd really like Japan to join the Axis, but I think we just haven't picked any of the decisions. We did start World War I a lot earlier than normal. Oh, Lithuania capitulated already. That's quite nice to see. And there's only two victory points here, so as long as we cover them, then we should be good. Yep. This guy. They can't cover all the land I'm trying to garrison, but... Oh, wrong troops, of course. Yes, I would like them to be there, actually. And then... To Copenhagen, please. Split them each half-half. And... Yeah, once the tanks are in position, we'll just go. And, Sometimes the AI does silly things like pulling a tank here instead of just shifting them all down one, but it's difficult to program that kind of thing, so I don't blame Paradox for the weirdness happening sometimes. we get paratroopers, how many transport? Lots of tactical bombers. We're still at essentially zero transport planes. Want to see how they are doing. A lot of the factories are damaged, it seems, which is why we're getting so low, such low production. Towers of construction. It's happening, so that's nice to see. I'll probably start researching military police so that we can get less of a malice when we do control these places. And, okay, here we go. Fighting Latvia. We would like to conquer him. And here we go. So, they joined the Allies, as usual. But they will fall almost immediately. Because none of the states in here have very good natural defenses. It would be nice to take Helsinki and go make Finland possibly a puppet state for the German Reich, but it might not be it might not be a good idea to poke the bear, the Russian bear. We could fight Denmark. They think they can win, so I'll give the troops the opportunity. Call allies. Excellent. And let's try it. Yes, yes, they're joining the war. And because you're not gonna go to Riga, you're gonna win it. Should actually help that out over here. The AI doesn't optimize as well as it should sometimes, but yeah. And then finally we'll just go for Estonia. Taking Denmark might be a bit more difficult because of the straits. I don't have naval superiority, so the Danish people might be able to hold the straits better than I can actually assault them, but eventually we'll be able to take them, whether it's through Denmark or through landing troops or even around Scandinavia if we wanted to be crazy about everything. Let's see, how's our infrastructure looking? It's pretty good. I would like a fast, essentially a line to the Russian front, just so that I could move troops back and forth if I absolutely had to. Schwerpunkt. In any operation, the Schwerpunkt, or focal point, must be identified and maximum force concentrated to win at that point. Oh, I think that'd be nice to have. 2 days. Yeah, the amassing of Russian troops along the Polish border is not something I want to see. Yeah. I think if we were going to fight Russia, we'd try to do some sort of war of attrition. Oh, Latvia's capitulated. Excellent. Good to see. And finally, I would like Estonia. And just let them go there. So we're moving in on here. It might be... we'll have to see how well we can do in taking the strait. We're taking the mainland quite easily, but the straits are not as simple. Here we go. The final of the Balkan states, making our border with Russia long enough that right now only really the Russians could easily place themselves along it. But if we make it long enough, they might make some points very thin, and all we have to do is hold a small location, and then we could pierce into them with some sort of arrowhead maneuver. So I'm not concerned so much with Russia at the moment, especially because they still have the officer's purge malice, which is just, it's really painful to have. Plus 35, minus 35% division organization, just cripples your power. And once these guys are done in Estonia, I will move them down to Romania, likely to push through any flatlands in the north. Can modify our government. think I'll worry about that a bit later. Once we take Estonia... Oh, excellent. So, where do we want to go next? Demand Slovenia, National Spirit. I think I'll go for the extra research slot, so we'll go for a strategic air effort. Yeah, strategic air effort. Go straight to Tallinn. And here we go. The capitulation should be now. Beautiful. We want our troops down here, along the northern border, because they are going to move along this way, pushing out and around, not touching the mountains of the Transylvania. But I believe that's where we'll stop. We do have our achievements, so campaign let's play objective achieved. True Blitz has been taken, and we still would have had a year to go if anything went worse. So it's going quite well. And thank you for watching Thomas Plays Games. I hope to see you all next time.